Assalamualaikum, my name is Umesh Masri. As you are watching my YouTube channel, welcome back to my channel. In this video we will see that how we can find the number of plates in a distillation column. Manually you can find by a number of methods using McCabe-Thiele and any other method that is easy for you, but in Aspenices how we can find the number of trays in distillation column. So let's start. How we can find, I will teach you in this video that how we can find the number of trays in Aspenices. So let's start. First of all, we will see the question, that is an example 11.7. It is present in Coulson and Richardson volume 2, that is the book for chemical engineering. The question states that a mixture of benzene and toluene containing 40% benzene and 60% toluene has to be separated such that top product will have 90% of benzene and the bottom product will have 90% should have 90% of toluene and 10% of benzene. You can pause the video and read the whole question, but another thing that is important and it is given, that is reflux ratio and the operating pressure on which the equilibrium diagram has been formed. The equilibrium data in this question has been given, that is 100 kilonewton per meter square. So let's start our simulation. First of all, we have to add the components. There in this we are having two components, that is are benzene and toluene. So I will add this benzene and our next is toluene. Next we have to add the fluid package. For fluid package, as we are will be dealing with vapor phase, so Penn Robinson is a very powerful when you are dealing with gases or vapor phases. So after this we will directly go to the simulation environment, because no reactions are involved. So in the reaction simulation environment, you have to select this separator, because distillation column is a separator that is used to separate. After clicking this separate, you have to select this shortcut column, not a distillation column, but we have to select the shortcut column for the calculation of the number of plates in Aspenices. So I will now double click it and I will name all the feed streams that are required. So I had inlet, I had named as feed. For condenser duty I will name this as C1. For distillate, and that will be from our top product, I will name this as top product. Top reboiler duty, it is, I will write as R1. And for bottom, that I will write as bottom. Here bottom I will be having toluene 90%, and in distillate according to question I should have 90% benzene and 10% toluene. So when I will click enter, it says that requires the product stream, and I think that I has missed is top product phase. The overhead product will be in vapor phase, there will be no liquid. So I will turn this into vapor phase. So now it will says that unknown key components. So I will go to these parameters and here I will name this key components. So light key in the bottom, that is benzene, and the heavy key in the distillate, and that is toluene, because heavy key is heavy key in both of the phases, but toluene because it has higher melting point, boiling point. So higher key in the distillate it is toluene, and the lighter key in the bottom that is benzene. So in the bottom we should have only 0.1% in the question, that were 10%, and in the top product it is also said in the question that you can only have toluene, that is 10%, 90% benzene should be there. So I had tried 0.1 and 0.1. Condenser pressure I will write as 100, because in the question 100 kilopascal was given to us, on which the diagram has been plotted. So another and the final and the last thing that was given in the question was the reflux ratio, that was 3. So I had write this 3, Now, feed not flash, because I had not given the feed composition, I have to write the temperature, pressure and mole flow rate. So temperature of the feed, you can take any temperature. I will take as 40 over here, you can write 35. So let's take 35, assume that it is warm outside and the summer. Just joking. So now after pressure, it is given in the question that the operating pressure on which the equilibrium diagram that was created, or you can say equilibrium data that is given, is on 100 kilopascal. So I had write 100 over here. Molar flow rate, it is not given in the question, you have to take it as a base. So I will write as 100 kilomole per hour, and I have to write its composition and composition. So now I will again go to the problem statement. It states that 40% benzene, so and the remaining after 40%, you know that we will have 60% toluene in the feed. So 40% benzene and 60% toluene. So when I will click OK, you will see that OK. So a green color has been popped up in the bottom, indicating that our question has been solved. So for finding the number of trays, we will just go to this performance. Actual number of trays is 7.8, nearly equal to 8. Minimum number of trays required for the separation is 5.143, and optimum feed tray, optimum feed location, that will be above 4th tray. So here you can see that rectifying vapor and rectifying liquid, if you know that rectifying vapor and rectifying liquid, in this particular example that I am taking, it is represented by ln, rectifying liquid as ln and vapor as vn. So you can find this ln vn, and stripping vapor and the stripping liquid that is present in the lower section. So in this particular example, it is represented by vm. Vm you can say for vapor and lm for liquids. So you can find this liquid vapor, liquid and vapor flow rates as well. So condenser duties you can find, and I condenser duties you can find, and many other things you can also find. You can find minimum reflux ratio. So I had tried to explain that how we can find number of trays, minimum number of trays and liquid flow rates in how you can find by simulation in Aspenices. I hope you will like the video, and meet you inshallah in another video, and please like, subscribe and share my channel. Assalamu alaikum.